हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल मैथ स्टडी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ न्यू कंसेप्ट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स, बट बिफोर दैट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ इमेजिनरी नंबर्स। सो टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट, लेट अस कंसीडर अ इक्वेशन। वील टेक अ सिंपल इक्वेशन, एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस वन इज इक्वल टू जीरो। नाउ हियर इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द इक्वेशन, वी हैव एक्स स्क्वायर। Now we will find the value of x in such a way that so that the right hand side should be equal to the left hand side. Now if you search the numbers, you'll find that no such number exists. There is no such number, or we can say that there is no such real number. Now how to move forward? As there is no real number, if we take the meaning of real, its opposite is imaginary. The thing which is not real in the world, it is imaginary. So we are going to see the imaginary numbers. In this way, the imaginary concept develops. First of all, we will see how to denote the imaginary numbers. For that we use Greek letter. It looks like I, but it is called iota or just ita. It is equal to under root minus 1, or if you take square of both the sides, you will get I square is equals to minus 1. So the equation which we have taken earlier, x square plus 1 is equal to 0, here in place of x square, if we put I and take its square, and if we solve it, you will find that both the sides are zero. So in this way we got a number which is satisfying our equation, and such a number is called an imaginary number. I, it is a imaginary number. Now, this number was developed by Leonhard Euler. It's a great mathematician. We will see how the definition of imaginary number will be there, how we are going to define those numbers. So here we are writing imaginary number. Now, as we have seen earlier, they are denoted by I. Here we will say that the number in the form bi. Now here we have taken b and I. Along with I, b is taken. This b belongs to the set of real numbers. It is a real number, and let me remind you that it should never be equal to zero, where, as we all know, our I is nothing but under root minus 1. So this is the definition of imaginary number. Let us take an example. Suppose under root minus 36 can be written as minus 1 into 36 under root. Under root minus 1 and under root 6, if we separate under root 36, if we separate them, under root minus 1, under root 36 can be written as 6, and under root minus 1 can be written as I, as we have defined it earlier, I. So under root minus 36 is nothing but 6i. In this way we have taken an example of imaginary number. Now we will move on to our main definition, which is nothing but complex numbers. Okay, so what is complex number? As the name suggests, it is complex. So we will take the definition first. The definition is like this: the number in the form a plus ib. Now here we have taken two parts, a and ib. We have already defined the ib part, means the imaginary part. So here your A is called a real part and IB is nothing but imaginary part. Okay guys, so these two combines, the real part and the imaginary part combines to form complex number. So actually the complex number is made up of two parts. The real part is normally written RE in bracket Z, or simply you can write it as R in bracket Z. For the imaginary part, we use the notation IM in bracket Z, or simply I in bracket Z. So in this way, we have defined a complex number. Now, we will see some examples how these complex numbers look like. As you see in this table, we have some columns Z, A plus IB, real Z, imaginary Z. Now, small Z is the notation for complex numbers. Okay, so the first number is 2 plus 4i. Now, if you compare this 2 plus 4i with A plus IB, here your real part means A will be 2, your imaginary part or I of Z is 4. Similarly, if you take another number which is just 5i, so in 5i there is no real part, so we have, instead of writing 5i, we have written is like this 0 plus 5i. So overall, if you see the definition of complex number, it is the set of A plus IB numbers such that A plus IB, where A, B both are real numbers, always both are real numbers, and I is equal to under root minus 1. I hope students you like this video. We are going to make similar videos. Okay, so please subscribe our channel. Thank you very much.